Visibility is probably the number one thing for growing at the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. We need to continue to create a strong fan base, and female sports is only going to take off from there.
Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. For us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. It's an exciting moment for women's hockey. There wasn't one tipping point that set us off to, you know, fight for women's rights and equal pay. Our contract hadn't changed in over like 20 years, and then we had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We're not gonna end up going to World Championships unless we get the right and correct support from USA Hockey. And so for us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. It was awesome to see how much support we had around the US, all the youth teams, college teams leading into the tournament. We showed up only a couple days before, and I knew we were gonna win the tournament heading in, even without the pre-camp and preparation. I think we just had an unbreakable bond that no one could really stand up against. So at the NHL All-Star Game, I ended up doing pretty well, but I didn't understand the hype and everything or the hashtag paydecker until maybe the next day, the next morning, I realized my phone was blowing up pretty good. There was a young fan, a young girl who ended up videotaping it, and that's what made everything blow up and be an exciting moment for women's hockey. I think there's still some work to be done as far as working with USA Hockey and making sure that we're getting everything that we do deserve. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. You know, advice to younger girls playing, I just be fearless out there. You know, you're gonna have people who are gonna tug away at you and wanna tear you down, but just be fearless and have fun with what you're doing.
Leading up to the All-Star weekend, I didn't really know the conversations that were being had up until 4 hours before when I got a call that said, you're going to be the first woman to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition. I was so excited because I knew this moment was going to break a lot of barriers, it was going to open a lot of doors, and it was going to change the landscape of women's hockey forever. When I got to the starting line, I do remember feeling the pressure of knowing that I cannot fall, I cannot stumble. You have to have a clean run or the narrative changes to I told you so, the women don't belong. As soon as the whistle blew, I just went and everything was a blur. And 14.346 seconds later, here we are. It was a moment that proved women belong in the sport of ice hockey, and a moment that all of us have worked so hard for. That's the moment you dream about. We were able to showcase ourselves at the NHL level, and so I think it's time that we start to get the respect that we deserve. We're put in the same conversation. We're all hockey players. There's a lot of stereotypes that come with playing a sport that's considered male dominant. I've heard it all. I've been told I'm not big enough, not strong enough. So just to be a visible, living proof that you can accomplish anything you set your mind to, regardless of your size. It is pretty cool, and it just makes me so excited to see all these young girls sending videos to me of them skating and doing their lap, and now they can aspire to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition because that barrier has been broke.
Growing up, I played on a guys' team. There weren't many girls playing that I knew of, so that was really my only option. There were some teams that would say that I didn't belong on the ice, and why are you playing guys' hockey? And that didn't stop me. I just wanted to get better, and I knew I was talented enough to be there, and I deserved to be playing. So if anyone ever went through what I had went through, and I think just use it as motivation and prove them wrong. Just be strong and fight for what you believe in and what you want. I was almost born into playing hockey. My dad played, and my two older sisters and older brother played at the time. So when I was 4 years old, I started playing on the outdoor rink, actually. It was like minus 30, and I was just having the time of my life. And so I think that's when I started to fall in love with hockey. Growing up, I played on the guys' team. There weren't many girls playing that I knew of, so that was really my only option. There were a lot of aspects of it that were challenging. There were some teams that would say that I didn't belong in the ice, and why are you playing guys' hockey? And that didn't stop me. I just wanted to get better, and I knew I was talented enough to be there, and I deserved to be playing. And I had a lot of support, a great team that I was on, and great coaching staff, and they all believed in me, and I think it really helped me develop as a hockey player. So if anyone ever went through what I had went through, and I think just use it as motivation and prove them wrong. You know, don't let anyone bring
visibility is probably the number one thing for growing the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. When I was about 10 years old, I had the opportunity to attend Becky Keller's female hockey camp. Becky Keller is a four-time Olympian for the Canadian national team, and that was really my role model. Getting in the community is super important, and that's why I started my own hockey camp in the summer to hopefully inspire girls just like Becky Keller did that for me. In order for them to stay in sport, to continue playing sport, to sign up for sport, they need to have those female role models, and I take a lot of pride in that. There's a lot of talent in female athletes in professional sports, and we need to continue to create a strong fan base, and that starts with the whole sports industry taking part, and that's from media, that's from sponsorship, that's from brands. As soon as we get them all on board, we'll start to increase that fan base, and then female sports is only going to take off from there.
We all have dreams. Ours is for a league.
A place that showcases,
celebrates,
and fairly compensates
the best female hockey players
in the world.
In the world.
In the world.
A place that inspires young girls
to become professional hockey players
or anything else they want to be.
But right now,
that league doesn't exist.
There's a gap.
But we believe,
with hard work
and the support of the hockey community,
our dream for a league will come true.
So future generations of girls
can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Boom! Hello out there, we're on the air.
It's hockey night tonight.
Tension grows, the whistle blows,
and the puck goes down the ice.
The goalie jumps, and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. So roar, bloody score, the good old hockey game.
Oh,
the good old hockey game. It's the best game you can name, and the best game you can name is a good old hockey game.
Where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind.
They grab the puck and go bursting up. They're down across the line.
In 2018, a lack of funding collapsed a women's game. The good old hockey game is only that when it's good to everyone.
So Budweiser has committed to sponsor the women's game. This is step one towards rebuilding a future. For the game we all love,
we need others to step up too.
This game is for us all.
For us all.
For us all.
For us all.
Because the best game you can name should be the good old hockey game.
We'll be right back.
Angela takes the ice, it's always scary. When she first started playing hockey, we didn't know she had osteogenesis imperfecta. People call it brittle bone disease. Her bones technically aren't brittle. They'll break with less trauma.
I was born with a broken collarbone. I've broken my elbows 3 or 4 times, both wrists 6 or 7 times.
She's torn her MCL 3 times, 5 dislocations.
I broke my ribs, a couple of my toes.
She broke her proximal humerus, she broke her ankle.
We might have broken a couple of my fingers, but we stopped counting at 20 fractures when I was 10 years old.
People tell me that I'm crazy for letting her play, but for her, hockey is everything. Why would we not let her do what she loves?
This one thing, I want to let her have. I want to let her have hockey.
Every minute I get to play hockey, I would. I'd do it all day, every day. I get in that net and my mind just clears and it's just me and the puck. I play with the boys because they're stronger and faster. When we step out on the ice, they rely on me to make the saves. They realize I'm not just a girl in net, I'm a goalie in net.
I'm so proud of her, for her willingness to go out there and fight. It's unbelievable what she does.
The look on the boys' faces whenever I take my helmet off and they realize the girl just saved their shot, it's priceless.
I love when you hear people leaving the rink. That was a girl. That goalie was a girl. They all act surprised.
Like girls can't play hockey.
Just because someone tells you you can't doesn't mean you actually can.
That kid has had to fight and work harder. And she has to do it knowing in the back of her mind that every day might be the last day she gets to play hockey.
I want to play as long as I'm able to. I tell everybody I'm going to play in the NHL just because I say I can't. I want to prove them wrong.
Thank you. Well, 6:36 p.m., it's officially hockey night. And another great game coming up, game three of the Secret Deodorant PWHPA Dream Gap Tour. Tonight from the Herbert H. Carnegie Arena, we've got Team Coyne and the Spooner Sharks, captained by, of course, Kendall Coyne and Natalie Spooner. Spooner Sharks in white on the left side of your screen, and Kendall Coyne's team in dark jerseys on the right side. Spooner Sharks primarily made up of women who used to play for the Toronto Furies with Natalie Spooner, of course. Notable names like Renata Fast, Sarah Nurse, Laura Fortino, who did used to play for the Markham Thunder, but has joined this team that's a close amalgamation of those kind of more outside of the GTA, maybe a bit more at least removed from the core Toronto area. Three folks from Hamilton, Ontario on this team, including Fortino and Nurse. Meanwhile, Kendall Coyne's team, decent amount of women from the Minnesota area, and not too many of them played in the CWHL, but joining up with the PWHPA to support the cause, which of course, as the title sponsor, Secret Deodorant, joining the PWHPA to advocate for meaningful change where all professional hockey players receive the same opportunities regardless of gender. Just about ready for the drop of the puck, game three, here on YouTube and CBC Jam. And the top line for the Spooner Sharks. Wins a faceoff, dumps it into the offensive zone. That's Lee Steckline on the puck. She's lost it. Sarah Nurse almost took it away from her, but she managed to flip it out to center where Melissa Channel met it, and Laura Fortino got it up the far side. We've got three number 12s for Kendall Coyne's team, so hopefully I can get them right as often as I can. And Renata Fast goes back into her own end. Fast with a pass ahead for Cheyenne D'Arcangelo. Couldn't quite get it to go through. Now carrying the puck in, Bailey Larson. Still on it, but just offside at the Spooner Sharks blue line. Face off won by Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson. You notice the Lamoureux sisters on this team. High up at the top of the near circle, and it's muscled out to center by Brittany Howard and thrown down into the offensive zone where Caroline Prevost tries to come to it. Nice away from her, and Lamoureux lost an edge. Prevost's back on the puck, tried to center it. It bounced on her, though. She gets it out in front and just off the skate of Sydney Kidd. She was all alone in front. Reagan Rust flips it out to center, directed right back in, and Prevost now over the line. Kidd still on it, tried to drag it behind her. Fortino pinches in. Flipped around and just out to center. Spooner has to wait for her teammates to get onside, and Natalie Spooner works it into the near corner. Round back of the net, meets with Lauren Williams. Good strip play by Lauren Gable. And just off her skate there, Fast at the line. Flipped it on net, and Spooner was in front for the tip, but Alex Cavallini makes the save. Cavallini, prominent member of Team USA in goal, formerly Rigsby, of course, but it's no secret that she got married and changed her name to Cavallini, but has been absolutely incredible in net for the United States. Multiple gold medals for her, including 2018 Olympic gold, of course, and won the Clarkson Cup in 2019. As Amanda Makula on the other side has to be sharp, and she makes the save with the blocker off Danny Cameronisi in front. Cameronisi's on it again. Got it out for Hannah Brand. Brand couldn't get a good shot away and fast took Kendall Coyne into the boards. Coyne gives her a shot as she tries to handle the puck. Got it back to the line for Steckline. Steckline in deep. Turn back to the line. Over to the far side. Steckline again playing pitch and catch here. Big shot from Lamoureux. Lamoureux Davidson returns it to the line. Steckline again. Goaltender is out of the net, so six attackers for Team Coyne. And finally touched up by Spooner. And fast is going off for body checking. She took Coyne into that far corner. A little too hard. And back to the line. This is Williams holding it in on this first power play. 14 Coyne, Fortino carries it out through center and wires one just wide of the net. Howard tried to get there. She took a hack at it, but it was tipped up. And now carry it out through center. Two of them collide. Lamoureux and Sperling, I believe. Excuse me, Rust. They carry it out. So here comes Sarah Nurse, shot off a stick. And out of play. Face off to the right of Cavallini, comes back, but Julia Fedeschi was already skating backwards, and Coyne came to it. Pass in front for Cameronisi, out of her reach. Knocked away by Fedeschi. Nurse couldn't corral it though. Spooner tried to work over. Centering pass again. Just knocked away by Brand. In deep for Coyne. The far side now. That's Hannon. Savannah Harmon, pardon me. One of the 3-12s. Gets it over to the far side. The shot looking for the rebound. Brand. The puck rolled on her, and it was cleared out to center. Coyne, pass off to Brand. Intercepted by Prevo, and Prevo could be away shorthanded. She tries to cut to the middle and just flipped it wide. Prevo still on the forecheck. Cameronisi. The pass off to Harmon. Fired it in deep. It's Melissa Channel. Got it up the far boards with the help of Fortino, and out through center is Howard. Brittany Howard slaps one that's blockered away by Cavallini. And Howard finds the loose puck in the offensive zone. The penalty's over. Howard with a move to try and sneak one on the far side, but it went off the side of the net. Channel just holds it in. Just for a moment, Panic carries it out through center. Kelly Panic into the offensive zone. Lamoureux with a toe drag, and the puck is bouncing in the slot. Knocked away by the Sharks. Makula sharp in net to start for the Spooner Sharks. Here goes Brand with a pass ahead for Sperling. Caitlin Sperling couldn't quite handle it. It's back in deep. Taken away by Nurse, chipped into the near corner. And Sarah Nurse trying to centering pass is cut by Carrie Atkinson. Here comes the near hash marks. Nurse found it again, a wrist shot right on. The rebound, knocked to the far boards, but Nurse held it in. Jessica Platt was over there. And the puck was thrown out of play. Face off outside the Team Coyne zone. Team Coyne sponsored by Greenwin. Knocked ahead by Cameron Easy, but all the way down the ice. So an icing call as Fortino got back there first. Won the draw. It's fired on net just wide by Channel and flipped out to center by Coyne. Fortino tried to hit Prevo, and now Coyne springs ahead. Can't step around Fortino. Coyne is definitely one you don't want to have get by you. One of the fastest skaters in women's and men's hockey. Of course, she ran the fastest skater competition last year at the NHL All-Star Game. Tipped ahead by Callie Panic. She gave chase, but Emma Greco got there first. And now pass ahead for Lauren Gable, 2-on-1. Gable is in, she fanned on the shot. Nurse was there with her and has the puck now, given off to Gable again. Up high for Spooner, blockered away by Cavallini. Greco pinched in. Spooner just out of her reach, but Faust came to it. Spun and fired it to the open near corner. Spooner let it go, but one of her teammates were there to help her out. And now Vinkel, Cassidy Vinkel, trying to come up with the puck. Faust looking for a call. Not down is Mackenzie McNeil. And now out comes Spooner with it, taken away from her by Kirion. Catherine Kirion, wearing number one. She's on the puck now. Tries to get it in front. That's knocked down by Greco and cleared out to center. Howard for McNeil, but had her stick lifted by Megan Turner. And is taken right back by Jenna Dingledine. She found Howard in the slot, who whistled it just wide of the net. Ahead for Turner. And Turner was upended, but now comes out to center. Prevo. She's really quick too. Tried to work past Harmon. Couldn't quite do it though. Intercepted by Taylor Woods. And Woods on the puck now, carries it over the blue line. Lanced away from her by Turner and just flipped into the offensive zone. Macula out to play it. Fortino, lead pass for Woods. She flips it into center ice area. That's taken away by Chelsea Goldberg. Goldberg worked over by Spooner. Laura Fortino got the puck and it's banked out to center by Michelle Saunders. Back in for Goldberg. She's bumped off the puck by Fortino. And now Nurse from behind her own net. Spun around and fell. She tried to get away from Goldberg. And flipped off the glass and out to center by Saunders. Spooner took the puck away just for a moment. Steckline made sure it got to one of her teammates and it was fired in deep. Fortino on the other side. Saunders has to get there. And Gable tried to muscle her way there too. Shot into traffic. Coyne was there to get a deflection. Now bounces to Spooner, who sends it across to Gable, and Gable turns away as their teammates go for a change. Was off a stick, but D'Arcangelo picks it up. Howard fires wide. Fast on the rebound. Into the near corner and takes it round to the far side. Fast still on it. Pass for Dingledine goes off a stick and out to center. Fast again, rips it into the offensive zone. Cavallini out to play it. Rust almost lost control of the puck, and D'Arcangelo digging away for it. Williams now in the near corner. Fired ahead. Knocked with a high stick by Larson. It was touched by a shark first. Larson got tied up in the corner. It was with Emma Greco, and it came out in front, and Vinkel's knocked down. And Renata Fast is going back to the box. It's a roughing call after the whistle. Harmon holds it in. Puck changing hands. Now centering pass for Steckline, and Mäkelä made the save. Great pass into the high slot for Lee Steckline. On the second power play for Team Coyne. Bounces out to center, Harmon sends it back for Steckline. Howard on the penalty kill. Doing a forecheck. Sent in deep, Mäkelä plays it for Channel. It's out of the reach of Fortino though, and Coyne is on it now. Coyne to the line for Harmon. The far side for Steckline. Steckline back pedals and sends it in deep for Cameron Easy. Centering pass through a bunch of sticks and nobody got a touch on it. To the line, Steckline. Deep Cameron Easy at the top of the far circle. Steckline return for Cameron Easy. She walks in and fired it off her own player, but the rebound for Coyne, and she scores. Kendall Coyne, the captain, and possibly the most decorated player on the ice right now, puts her team up 1-0 off the rebound. And Hannah Brand is going to get an assist on it simply because it ricocheted right off her hand. That's not ever going to feel good. But on the power play, Kendall Coyne has tied the game. Thrown in by Team Coyne. Fedeski to the far side, gloved down by Gable, and puck was bouncing on her. She had to regain control of it before she made a play, and now she sent it forward for Spooner. Sorry, that's Spooner now. Nurse was the intended receiver of the initial pass. Nurse tried to check Rust. It's out through center now. Larson, drop pass, mishandled. The point shot was tipped wide, wrapped back out in front. And thrown out to center now. Here goes Spooner. Gable is with her. Gable peels off for a change. Spooner just trying to maintain possession. Fast now. Tried to center it off a stick. Like it was off the stick of Atkinson. And out of play. Another close game. The 1-1 tie. Excuse me, 1-0 for Kendall Coyne. far side. Kirion plays it out through center. And Panic just muscles it past D'Arcangelo. Tried to center it. D'Arcangelo took that away. Taken right back by Turner. Out of the near side. Fast, got it to the line, but not out. Atkinson held it in. Her shot was blocked by Wood, but she didn't know where it was. So Fast came to it in the near corner. Pass intercepted by Howard. And now Woods is away. Taylor Woods dropped for Brittany Howard. Back in front, and the bouncing puck knocked away by Cavallini. Sent back to the line. Fortino faked the shot. Turner was in the way. Now she takes one. And nobody knows where the puck is. It bounces back of the net. Prevost regained control. Fortino slap pass tipped on. Another good save by Cavallini. Kidd fired that just wide. Now in the high slot, Prevost took over. Tries to gain full control of it, but ricocheted off a couple of sticks, and another penalty's coming to Team Spooner. Sydney Kidd going off for tripping. Great tracking of the puck by Cavallini on that give and go between Howard and Woods, and another penalty to kill for the Spooner Sharks. Nurse can't clear it out. Fast in the far corner. Lost the puck to Steckline. Fast and Steckline still battling. Now Brand behind the net. Brand. Harmon at the top of the near circle. Spooner watching her. In deep for Brand. Back to Steckline at the far point. No shot. Off to Coyne. Tried to hit Harmon as she was headed to the net. Would have had an open tip in. Coyne. Nice little move through the legs to just get it to the line. And Harmon held it in. Steckline. Brand. Coyne wires one, and that's stopped by Mäkelä. One back again, Lamoureux. Held it in. Down to the far side, now near side. Centering pass, taken away. Channel just gets it out and down the ice. Howard again on the forecheck on the penalty kill. Panic. Still carrying it through neutral ice and down the near side. Stops up and her team sets up now. Lamoureux looking for an option. Can't quite find one. Turns back. At the line, Williams fired one wide of the net. Panic. In the near corner. Back across for Williams again. Tried to get one on. Morrison was there, but was intercepted and cleared out. Steckline. Right back in again. Panic chipped it past Gable. Fortino in her own zone for Foss now. Foss steps by Turner and sent it ahead for Kidd as she came out of the box. Brand whips it out and into the offensive zone where Foss meets it. Can't get a breakout play going, but puck's returned to her by Greco. And they play pitch and catch as there's two Team Coyne players in deep. Nurse off a stick. In the neutral zone, D'Arcangelo just shoveled it into the offensive zone. She's on the puck now, being watched by Turner. Her pass was out of the way of Faust, and it's dumped in. Banked out and down the ice. and actually out into the bench of the Spooner Sharks. Just under 2.5 minutes left in the first period. Kendall Coyne got her team up 1-0 on the power play, and her team's had three so far tonight. Nurse off the faceoff win. Just threw that towards the net and goes off for a change. Pass now for Cameron Easy. Coyne goes to the net. Drop pass and they score. Kelly Panic with the shot. Kendall Coyne obviously going to the net to draw attention away from Panic, who was wide open in the high slot. There goes Coyne straight down the middle, but Panic was left alone in the high slot and Makula couldn't find it. And it's a 2-0 lead for Team Coyne. Fast, near own end. Makes it through center. Teammates wait for her to get the puck in and stay onside. He's turned over and Lamoureux receives the pass and a 2-on-1. Winkle was in there with her. She just got a weak shot away. Atkinson mishandled the puck and Howard is free with a 2-on-1 the other way. Brittany Howard scores! She had Lauren Gable with her, but didn't need her. She ripped that far side on Cavallini. And Team Spooner's got one back. The Sharks are down just by one now. Face-off win. This is Team Coyne. Kendall tried to knock it down and neutral ice. And that's played up through center. D'Arcangelo was tied up, couldn't receive the pass. Panic is upended by Spooner as she tried to work her way in, and Spooner's going to go off to her dismay. It's a kneeing call against Natalie Spooner as Panic tried to work her way past. And the fourth power play of the game for Team Coyne. They're 1-for-3 so far. Deep for Cameron Easy. Returned and out of the line, Steckline. Shot tipped wide. It was off the body of Greco. Went into the near corner. Battle for it. Dug out by Howard, but turned over to Coyne. Changing hands. Puck bounces through the slot. Coyne tried to get there. She had to turn away. Prevost was checking her. To the near top of the circle, Harmon. Her pass was off a body, and Prevost flips that out to center. Steckline in her own zone. Pass ahead off the skate of Gold of Cameron Easy, and in deep. Gable couldn't clear it. Stripped of the puck by Lamoureux, and that's turned over. Channel passed it ahead for Gable. And Gable threw it right back out to center. And that does it, actually, for the first period. I wasn't even paying attention to the time. Was so invested in this game. 2-1 for Team Coyne over the Spooner Sharks at the end of the first period. Kendall Coyne opened the scoring, and Panic on the power on the rush made it 2-1. Brittany Howard got one back for the Spooner Sharks. I'm going to head down and catch an interview for you folks and be back here on YouTube and CBC Jam in a few moments. Here with Kendall Coyne, she opened the scoring for her team on the power play off a rebound and a bit of a uncomfortable assist for Hannah Brand, but what did you see on that first goal?
I think we were doing a good job moving it on the power play and, you know, a little bit of a block shot that led to a rebound that led to a goal, so a great effort by everyone on the ice.
Now, in the first game, I was up with Liz Knox in the press box, and she was telling me how a lot of the members of Team Kessel flew in last night. Did you have a similar thing to deal with, or did you have a bit more time to get ready for tonight's game?
I think almost majority of our team flew in last night. A few plane delays, a few long travel trips, but we're here and we're having a blast.
Well, that's good, and you don't look too sluggish out there. Kendall will be back for the second period, and so will we here on YouTube and CBC Jam.
visibility is probably the number one thing for growing the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. We need to continue to create a strong fan base, and female sports is only going to take off from there.
Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. For us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. It's an exciting moment for women's hockey. There wasn't one tipping point that set us off to, you know, fight for women's rights and equal pay. Our contract hadn't changed in over like 20 years, and we had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We're not gonna end up going to World Championships unless we get the right and correct support from USA Hockey. And so for us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. It was awesome to see how much support we had around the US, all the youth teams, college teams leading into the tournament. We showed up only a couple days before, and I knew we were gonna win the tournament heading in, even without the pre-camp and preparation. I think we just had an unbreakable bond that no one could really stand up against. So at the NHL All-Star Game, I ended up doing pretty well, but I didn't understand the hype and everything, or the hashtag paydecker, until maybe the next day, the next morning, I realized my phone was blowing up pretty good. There was a young fan, a young girl, who ended up videotaping it, and that's what made everything blow up and be an exciting moment for women's hockey. I think there's still some work to be done as far as working with USA Hockey and making sure that we're getting everything that we do deserve. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. You know, advice to younger girls playing, I just be fearless out there. You know, you're gonna have people who are gonna tug away at you and wanna tear you down, but just be fearless and have fun with what you're doing.
Leading up to the All-Star Weekend, I didn't really know the conversations that were being had up until 4 hours before, when I got a call that said, you're going to be the first woman to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition. I was so excited because I knew this moment was going to break a lot of barriers, it was going to open a lot of doors, and it was going to change the landscape of women's hockey forever. When I got to the starting line, I do remember feeling the pressure of knowing that I cannot fall, I cannot stumble. You have to have a clean run or the narrative changes to, I told you so, the women don't belong. As soon as the whistle blew, I just went and everything was a blur. And 14.346 seconds later, here we are. It was a moment that proved women belong in the sport of ice hockey, and a moment that all of us have worked so hard for. That's the moment you dream about. We were able to showcase ourselves at the NHL level, and so I think it's time that we start to get the respect that we deserve. We're put in the same conversation. We're all hockey players. There's a lot of stereotypes that come with playing a sport that's considered male dominant. I've heard it all. I've been told I'm not big enough, not strong enough. So just to be a visible, living proof that you can accomplish anything you set your mind to, regardless of your size. It is pretty cool, and it just makes me so excited to see all these young girls sending videos to me of them skating and doing their lap, and now they can aspire to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition because that barrier has been broke.
Growing up, I played on a guy's team. There weren't many girls playing that I knew of, so that was really my only option. There were some teams that would say that I didn't belong on the ice, and why are you playing guys hockey? And that didn't stop me. I just wanted to get better, and I knew I was talented enough to be there and I deserved to be playing. So if anyone ever went through what I had went through, and I think just use it as motivation and prove them wrong. Just be strong and fight for what you believe in and what you want.
Visibility is probably the number one thing for growing the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. When I was about 10 years old, I had the opportunity to attend Becky Keller's female hockey camp. Becky Keller is a four-time Olympian for the Canadian national team, and that was really my role model. Getting in the community is super important, and that's why I started my own hockey camp in the summer to hopefully inspire girls just like Becky Keller did that for me. In order for them to stay in sport, to continue playing sport, to sign up for sport, they need to have those female role models, and I take a lot of pride in that. There's a lot of talent in female athletes in professional sports, and we need to continue to create a strong fan base, and that starts with the whole sports industry taking part, and that's from media, that's from sponsorship, that's from brands. As soon as we get them all on board, we'll start to increase that fan base, and then female sports is only going to take off from there.
We all have dreams. Ours is for a league.
A place that showcases,
celebrates,
and fairly compensates
the best female hockey players
in the world.
In the world.
In the world.
A place that inspires young girls
to become professional hockey players
or anything else they want to be.
But right now,
that league doesn't exist.
There's a gap.
But we believe,
with hard work
and the support of the hockey community,
our dream for a league will come true.
So future generations of girls
can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Boom! Hello out there, we're on the air.
It's hockey night tonight.
Tension grows, the whistle blows,
and the puck goes down the ice.
The goalie jumps, and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. So we're all our bloody score, the good old hockey game.
Oh, the good old hockey game.
The best game you can name, and the best game you can name,
is a good old hockey game.
Where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind.
They grab the puck and go bursting up. They're down across the line.
In 2018, a lack of funding collapsed a women's game. The good old hockey game is only that when it's good to everyone.
So Budweiser has committed to sponsor the women's game. This is step one towards rebuilding a future. For the game we all love,
we need others to step up too.
This game is for us all.
For us all.
For us all.
For us all.
Because the best game you can name should be the good old hockey game.
We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Second period action about to get underway between the Spooner Sharks and Team Coyne Greenwin. Team Coyne holding a 2-1 lead. They jumped out 2-0 and have had four power plays in the first period. One of them's carried over. Natalie Spooner still sits in the box for kneeing. Another 40 seconds. Another strong forecheck on the penalty kill by Prevost. And a long lead pass now for Cameron Easy. Back for Coyne. She takes it into the far corner, banked it to Brand. Pitch and catch between Brand and Steckline. Cameron Easy at the top of the near circle. Return to the line, Steckline, high shot, rising up. Makala had to fight it off. Comes to the line, settled and held in by Steckline. Howard rips it off and out to center though. Steckline. Spooner's about to come out of the box. And Steckline carries it herself. Gave it off, she thought she was gonna get Brand. And now could be a 2-on-1 for the Sharks. Nurse held up a little too long and Gable was in on her own, so she just fired that one on net. And that was an easy stop. All squared up to the shot was Cavallini. A soft one by Lamoureux. The near side, centering pass. Cut and carried out now. Flipped in the offensive zone by Vinkel. Up the near boards. Nurse butted out to center. Banked right back in by Williams. Greco on the turnover. Skates it through neutral ice. Flips it in. Gives chase herself. It's taken away by Rust. At the line, Spooner stick handled and flipped it to the near corner. Prevost muscled it to Woods and the puck is loose in the slot. Kidd knocked down Vinkel as she tried to find the bouncing puck in front. Lamoureux now being watched by Kidd and Fortino. Lamoureux spins away, throws it to the open side for Kirion. Kirion tried to get it back. Bouncing puck off a couple of bodies. And Makala found it, though. Made sure that that didn't get anywhere. Good tracking of the puck by Amanda Makala. She has to be sharp again as that ricochets off some more legs. Bounce to the line. Poked ahead by Prevost. Gets it in. Out of the far side channel. Reversed it to Prevost, and Prevost skates it back to the line. Fedeschi on the near point. Directed to the back wall by Cavallini. Sent back in, picked off by Prevost. Prevost muscled off the puck. Knocked down by Turner. And it's carried out to center. Thrown right back for Kidd off her skate. She tries to work it in. That bounces past Melissa Channel. And now walking in, fought off by Makala on the shot from Turner. Centering pass again. Taken away by D'Arcangelo, and Kidd tried to dump it in. It was stopped at the line by Williams. Centering pass, Sperling couldn't handle it. The far side by Fedeschi. Banked to the line by Howard, not out. Now over to the near side here, Dingledine. Throws it to the line, it just gets out past Sperling. And here goes Howard now. Howard with a centering pass, there's really high. Dingledine tried to knock it down, sorry, D'Arcangelo. Dingledine is in front of the net, though, looking for the tip. She didn't get anything on it, though, and Cavallini made the save. Dingledine spent her PWHL career with one season with the Etobicoke Dolphins before playing two seasons with the Mississauga Chiefs, now the Mississauga Hurricanes, before joining the Toronto Furies after her time at Mercus University, I think. On in the offensive zone, Team Coyne. Drop pass return for Lamoureux, and wow, what a goal. Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson returned the pass that she got from Cameron Easy, and all alone in the slot, just waited for Makala to fall. She could have one-timed it, but the patience of Lamoureux allowed for the top of the net to open up even more, and she made no mistake, and now it's 3-1 for Team Coyne Green Wing. Laura Fortino turns away. Spooner tried to hit Nurse, but that's taken away. Puck changing hands. Goes in deep for Cameron Easy. Coyne off the back of the net, and it actually settles on the back of the net. So play is stopped. Kendall Coyne dug that out. Face off to the right of Makala, Thunder Bay, Ontario native. One quickly back to Finkel, and Makala caught that one in her shoulder and managed to hang on. Makala did spend 1 year in the NWHL for the Buffalo Buttes and then took a year off before joining the Toronto Furies once again. You can see representing the Furies well with her blue pads, as that's knocked out to center. Offside on the pass for Larson. So because of the pass that came just outside the Team Coyne zone, that's where it will be. In the feet of the linesman, comes to channel. She tried to bump it ahead. Prevo couldn't quite find it. She does a second time, only for a second. And Atkinson got it in deep with the help of Vinkel. Cassidy Vinkel on it again in the near corner. Comes to Larson, centering pass, knocked away, the rebound. Vinkel fired that just wide of the near side. Up and out of play off the stick. As Atkinson tried to get that in deep. Atkinson, another one of these women who spent at least a year abroad. She played for Djurgårdens IF in the Swedish Women's League for a season before returning to Canada, joining the Worcester Blades for the final year of the CWHL before it folded. Shot fought off to the far corner by Makala. Centering pass cut off by D'Arcangelo, but the Sharks can't clear. Sent back on net, and Makala directs that to the far corner. Now it does just squeak out of the line, and Brittany Howard away again. Howard down the same side that she scored in the first period. Bounces out in front, directed back to the far side. And I think D'Arcangelo might have thought that Howard would come back out to the front of the net, and that's why she threw it there. Nurse now, carrying it in, falls to her knees, jumps right back up. Great leg strength on Sarah Nurse to pop right back up, losing her edge. And Lauren Gable's drawn a call now. Looks like Steckline's going to go off for hooking. The far point, Greco tried to spin and fire that in deep, but he misfired, and Steckline is, in fact, going off for hooking. The first penalty for Team Coyne. Great effort on the part of Lauren Gable to draw the call. And a couple of young Scarborough Sharks having a chat with Steckline in the box. Perhaps asking for an autograph after the game. Fast, lost it in her feet. Now out goes Coyne. Look at the speed on Kendall Coyne to the middle, and she's stopped by Makula. Back out at center. Harmon fired all the way down the ice. Lamoureux on the forecheck, shorthanded. Wasting time on the penalty kill. Tried to center it in front for Coyne again. And Coyne gets tangled up in the far corner with Fast. Directed back for Nurse. Fortino behind her own net. Now she skates it out through the neutral ice. Dropped it for Nurse. And Nurse stick handles over the blue line and in deep. Goes round back of the net. Given off to Gable. At the near point, Greco. Greco walks in. That was off a stick and wide of the net. Gable returns it to the line. Fortino tried to muscle it past Coyne, and Fortino and Coyne go at each other a little bit, and a back check again by Coyne to break up the play with Nurse. Lamoureux spins and continues to control the puck, works to the front, and almost drew a hooking call. Her bench was asking for one as she cut to the front and felt a tug. Here's Spooner. Up the right wing side, muscled off the puck by Cameron Easy. And she sends it to her defensive player, and it's fired out and down the ice. Makula has to be sharp. She lost it in her feet. Was able to get it to Fortino. Here goes Prevost up the right wing. Her offside, and Prevost just put it through the legs of Atkinson and still has control. Knocked away from her, but Channel held the line. Steckline out of the box. Prevost in front. A good pass. What vision from Channel to find Prevost in that open slot. Now back out in front. Brand stopped by Makula too. Chances at either end now. Kirion at the line to the far corner. Bounces there for Fedeschi. These teams exchanging opportunities. Dingledine drags it with her. Into the middle for Howard. That's stop two. And the goaltenders battle each other here. Jenna Dingledine and Brittany Howard. Howard shaking her head as she goes to the bench. Here's the first breakaway for Kendall Coyne. Just accelerating away from everyone. Makula with the pad save. No time for the rest of the replays, but wow, what a sequence in this game as the speed really picks up. Still 3-1 for Team Coyne, about midway through this second period. Dingledine couldn't handle the pass and went down the ice for icing. Off to the left of Amanda Makula. Both goaltenders have been stellar in this second period. Goes straight to Makula. Lamoureux went right on net and Fast collided with her to make sure that action wasn't welcome. Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson, a six-time world champion, two-time Olympic silver medalist, and then also winning the gold in 2018 with the United States. tons of medals weighing her neck down as well. In the near corner, Gable got clipped by Nurse and now lost her stick as Lamoureux, another toe drag for Lamoureux, two toe drags, and she couldn't get the shot to go. 14-0 now. She's got Gable out through center. Couldn't handle the pass though. Lamoureux right back ahead the other way. Nurse on a turnover to Channel on the near side. Return to Nurse. She drags it through and carries it over the offensive blue line. Pass just behind Natalie Spooner. Goes into the near corner to dig it out. Comes to the front of the net where Steckline takes it round. Worked over by Spooner, but she left it for Sperling, I believe. No, that's Harmon. Thrown back out to center. Dumped right ahead again for Brand. Centering pass! Knocked away by Makula, and it bounced right back out in front. And Kendall Coyne with another great opportunity in front. Makula making the stop again. Kendall Coyne, a point per game player internationally for the United States. And that includes all tournaments. A breakout pass for Dingledine, didn't get her. And Cavallini almost dangerously played that puck, but kept the play going. Fast in her own zone, watched by Coyne. Puts on the brakes, and now almost stripped of the puck by Coyne. Bounces to the line. Atkinson almost held it in. Knocked out by Howard. Kidd didn't control it. Greco tried to flip it past some Team Coyne players. Cameron Nisi dropped it for Brand. Centering pass, cut, but Fast is poked away from her directly on Makula. She had to make a pad stop. Brand, no, that's Coyne. Cameron Nisi now. Spins away, back for Coyne in front. Again, Coyne sitting in that high slot. Couldn't get that shot away, though. Williams, watched by Howard. Tied up by Howard, but she couldn't get the puck away. Williams again, now in the far corner. Long pass, just tipped in. Off the stick of Vinkel. Out of the far corner, Fortino was tied up. Woods. Flipped it out to center, bounces down into the neutral zone. And Larson bumped by Channel as she tried to control the puck. And Panic took over. Panic's pass off the stick of Kidd. She regained it and sent it back for Steckline. Harmon up the far side, flipped out to center. And Channel threw it up the near boards. And this a gamble, couldn't quite handle it. Larson in deep. This is Vinkel, still on the puck with the help of Panic. Now taken away by Fortino. She turns away. Waits for her teammates to get set up. So now in comes Woods. Over that far blue line, flipped it in deep. On it again, Woods. And just dumping it in so that she can get off her chain. Gable found the loose puck. Centering pass in the slot is knocked down by Steckline. On the near corner. Sharp angle shot is gloved down and held onto by Cavallini. 6:16 left in the second period. Neither goaltender has given up a goal despite incredible play, well, except for Lamoureux, of course. That goal came, feels like so long ago that Lamoureux gave her team a 3-1 lead. Spooner right back in, shot off the stick of Panic, I believe. That was Rust. Turner carries it up the right wing side. Flips it past Fedeski. Fast back for it. And here goes Gable now. The top player in the NCAA last season. Shot kicked out by Makula into the near corner. D'Arcangelo to Fast on the far side. Just gets it ahead to Spooner, who backhands it out to center. And still a neutral ice. Atkinson to Kirion. Intercepted by D'Arcangelo, and Fortino followed up. Fortino is in now in the high slot. Off the post! The rebound for Dingledine goes wide. D'Arcangelo on it again. Stripped away from her by Cameronese. And that's flipped out and down the ice. All the way for an icing call, and it was Goldberg. The other 24, actually, was originally with the puck. Here is Fortino with a great rush ahead. And a shot fooled Cavallini and beat everything but the post. Saunders at the line. Knocked in by D'Arcangelo. Fortino pinching in to hold it. D'Arcangelo covered, and that shot patted away by Cavallini. Behind the net, Howard. Tied up by Brand. D'Arcangelo came in to help. Fortino at the line. Howard again. Fortino, slap shot. And Cavallini tracked it all the way. Made the stop. Kenzie McNeil out of Richmond Hill. Here again, we see Fortino. She loves to rip those slap shots from the point. But you'll need a bit more traffic to beat Cavallini, though, as they readjust the far post of the net, make sure that peg is in the ice good and firm. Cavallini supporting her national team mask. Here goes Cameronese now. Linked it off past Greco. Cameronese back out in front. Bounced round back of the net. Coyne is in the slot again. Prevost trying to clear that out. Panic held the line. Now Channel took a funny bounce off a stanchion. Makula saw it all the way, so she's able to cover up and make the stop. I'll take a moment to thank once again the partners of the PWHPA. Of course, Secret Canada, Budweiser Canada, the NHLPA, Adidas Hockey, Unifor Canada, BioSteel Sports, the Toronto Maple Leafs, Bauer Hockey, and Tim Hortons. The PWHPA thanks you for your support. Spooner. On the right wing side, sharp angle shot, easily snagged by Cavallini. She'll definitely take those all day, perimeter shots. And it'll be something that Spooner shirks to tune up for the third period, trying to get into that slot area, create some high danger chances against Cavallini, who is always spectacular. Warning given to Lamoureux on the face-off. Bounces. Nurse found it. Natalie Spooner's alone in front. Couple of whacks at it. Cavallini's down. They score! Natalie Spooner snuck her way to the front of the net. Took a couple of whacks at it. And looks like Lauren Gable was able to bank it past Cavallini. And And it's a one goal game once again. 3.5 to go, less than that in the second period. Harmon skates it herself. Fast knocked it away. And there's a tie up and back wall. Nurse dug it out. Gable, the goal scorer, into the middle for Spooner. Across for Fast, jumping up in the rush, the rebound. Nurse scores! Two quick goals, this one for Sarah Nurse on the rebound, wide open in the high slot, and this game is tied. See that rebound come out, and Nurse following up, originally covering for Renata Fast, who jumped up in the rush, and that is a gift, if anything, for any player. And she teed it up and has tied this game. Not a single game has been a blowout today, and we're in for a great third period. Still over 2 minutes, over 2.5 minutes left in this second. Greco at the line. In for Howard on the near side, return to Greco. Pitch and catch between her and Channel. Bounces around in the high slot. Dingledine's backhand over into the shoulder of Cavallini. Greco fired it in deep. Arcangelo goes after it. Settled it. Got it to Channel on the far side. Centering pass, bouncing around. Back out in front again. Lauren Gable almost found it. Diving to keep it alive is Greco. Gable for Nurse again, and that's off the stick of Turner and out of play. Another great sequence for the Spooner Sharks. Great keep at the line. But we'll rewind it back here again. Bounced out in front. And Gable off the post and back out, but Howard wasn't set to receive it. So we remain tied. Spooner trying to work her way to the high slot. She's upended. Cameron Easy into the middle for Coyne. Tries to drag it with her. Bumps into Fortino. And Nurse found the loose puck and got it up the near boards. Into the middle for Spooner again. Just off her skate, she couldn't quite corral it. Near Steck line. On her off wing, dumps it into the offensive zone. Fortino goes back. Down and Coyne, another shot. Rebound was there, poked at by Cameron Easy, I believe, and Coyne as well. Makala covering up. Greco up for Wood. She just got it out to center. Dumped right back in. Cut off by Greco on the attempted dump in by Rust. Cavallini comes out to play it, and with the forecheck of McNeil, she decides to cover up. Just over a minute left here in the second period in this 3-3 tie. Prevo tried to punch the draw forward. Lamoureux saw that. It's stolen away by McNeil again. Rust. Round back of the net. Larson tried to tip it up for Lamoureux. Larson muscled it ahead again. Lamoureux on that far side. Stick handling. She's ever so dangerous when she does that. Puck changes hands and Fast. Carrying it out now. Renata Fast still on the puck. Former Burlington Barracuda and occasional assistant coach with them this year. Of course, when she's got time, all these women are so busy. Fired right back in by Harmon. Fast goes to it with the final 10 seconds on the clock. There are some Barracuda fans here. Players, members of the Burlington Barracudas organization cheering on Renata Fast at the end of the second period. A 3-3 tie after two quick goals from Sarah Nurse and Lauren Cable for the Spooner Sharks to get back in it. And we'll return, have another interview down at ice level where I will head right now. And then we'll be back for another thrilling third period as day one of the Secret Deodorant Dream Gap Tour stop here in North York begins to come to a close. here ringside with Sarah Nurse. Couple of quick goals for your line specifically of Gable, yourself, and Natalie Spooner. What seems to be clicking now in the second period that you got something going?
Yeah, I think we had kind of a tough first period. We were on the kill a lot, so we didn't get a lot of five-on-five action. And so we know that when we get five-on-five, we have to make it count. So we had a good couple shifts, got some jump back in us, and it's a brand new game.
Well, I guess you can kind of blame Renata a little bit for that. But
she's a strong
girl. That she is. Going into the third period now, game's tied. It's been like this all day so far. Other two games really close. What's going to be the edge for you and your team going into the third?
I think we have to bear down and play really good defense. You know, we talk about it all the time, but defense wins championships. And so if we start from our D zone, goalie out, we're going to have a lot of fun and play in the offensive zone. So I'm really excited for this next period.
Sounds good. Maybe a bit of overtime on the line once again. Third period action coming up in the final game, game three of this Dream Gap Tour stop.
Visibility is probably the number one thing for growing into the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. We need to continue to create a strong fan base, and female sports is only going to take off from there.
Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. For us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. It's an exciting moment for women's hockey. There wasn't one tipping point that set us off to, you know, fight for women's rights and equal pay. Our contract hadn't changed in over like 20 years, and we had the right group of girls in the room that knew we could stand up against USA Hockey and fight for equal pay. Heading into World Championships in 2017, I think that's when we were like, let's take a stand. We're not going to end up going to World Championships unless we get the right and correct support from USA Hockey. And so, for us to be able to sacrifice that tournament, put it on the line, was a huge statement from our end. It was awesome to see how much support we had around the US, all the youth teams, college teams, leading into the tournament. We showed up only a couple days before, and I knew we were gonna win the tournament heading in, even without the pre-camp and preparation. I think we just had an unbreakable bond that no one could really stand up against. So at the NHL All-Star Game, I ended up doing pretty well, but I didn't understand the hype and everything or the hashtag paydecker until maybe the next day, the next morning, I realized my phone was blowing up pretty good. There was a young fan, a young girl who ended up videotaping it, and that's what made everything blow up and be an exciting moment for women's hockey. I think there's still some work to be done as far as working with USA Hockey and making sure that we're getting everything that we do deserve. There's still conversations that need to be had, but USA Hockey's done a great job putting their best foot forward right now, and we're excited to continue to work with them. You know, advice to younger girls playing, I just be fearless out there. You know, you're gonna have people who are gonna tug away at you and wanna tear you down, but just be fearless and have fun with what you're doing.
Leading up to the All-Star Weekend, I didn't really know the conversations that were being had up until 4 hours before when I got a call that said, you're going to be the first woman to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition. I was so excited because I knew this moment was going to break a lot of barriers, it was going to open a lot of doors, and it was going to change the landscape of women's hockey forever. When I got to the starting line, I do remember feeling the pressure of knowing that I cannot fall, I cannot stumble, You have to have a clean run or the narrative changes to I told you so. The women don't belong. As soon as the whistle blew, I just went and everything was a blur. And 14.346 seconds later, here we are. It was a moment that proved women belong in the sport of ice hockey, and a moment that all of us have worked so hard for. That's the moment you dream about. We were able to showcase ourselves at the NHL level, and so I think it's time that we start to get the respect that we deserve. We're put in the same conversation. We're all hockey players. There's a lot of stereotypes that come with playing a sport that's considered male dominant. I've heard it all. I've been told I'm not big enough, not strong enough. So just to be a visible, living proof that you can accomplish anything you set your mind to, regardless of your size, it is pretty cool, and it just makes me so excited to see all these young girls sending videos to me of them skating and doing their lap, and now they can aspire to compete in the NHL All-Star Skills Competition because that barrier has been broke.
Growing up, I played on a guy's team. There weren't many girls playing that I knew of, so that was really my only option. There were some teams that would say that I didn't belong on the ice, and why are you playing guys hockey? And that didn't stop me. I just wanted to get better, and I knew I was talented enough to be there and I deserved to be playing. So if anyone ever went through what I had went through, and I think just use it as motivation and prove them wrong. Just be strong and fight for what you believe in and what you want.
Visibility is probably the number one thing for growing the women's game. Growing up, I always felt like people didn't take my dream seriously of wanting to play professional women's sports. So being able to be on TV for young girls to watch us and to see us, and they can take away from us role models that it is possible to follow your dreams and to get to a point where you can play sports for a living. When I was about 10 years old, I had the opportunity to attend Becky Keller's female hockey camp. Becky Keller is a four-time Olympian for the Canadian national team, and that was really my role model. Getting in the community is super important, and that's why I started my own hockey camp in the summer to hopefully inspire girls just like Becky Keller did that for me. In order for them to stay in sport, to continue playing sport, to sign up for sport, they need to have those female role models, and I take a lot of pride in that. There's a lot of talent in female athletes in professional sports, and we need to continue to create a strong fan base, and that starts with the whole sports industry taking part, and that's from media, that's from sponsorship, that's from brands. As soon as we get them all on board, we'll start to increase that fan base, and then female sports is only going to take off from there.
We all have dreams. Ours is for a league.
A place that showcases,
celebrates,
and fairly compensates
the best female hockey players
in the world.
In the world.
In the world.
A place that inspires young girls
to become professional hockey players
or anything else they want to be.
But right now,
that league doesn't exist.
There's a gap.
But we believe,
with hard work
and the support of the hockey community,
our dream for a league will come true.
So future generations of girls
can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Can dream big too.
Boom! Hello out there. We're on the air.
It's hockey night tonight.
Tension grows, the whistle blows, and the puck goes down the ice.
The goalie jumps, and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. So we're all our bloody score, the good old hockey game.
Oh, the good old hockey game.
It's the best game you can name, and the best game you can name,
it's a good old hockey game.
Where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind.
They grab the puck and go bursting up. They're down across the line.
In 2018, a lack of funding collapsed a women's game. The good old hockey game is only that when it's good to everyone.
So Budweiser has committed to sponsor the women's game. This is step one towards rebuilding a future. For the game we all love,
we need others to step up too.
This game is for us all.
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 Because the best game that you can name should be the good old hockey game.
Here we go, everybody. The third period of this 3-3 tie between Team Coyne and the Spooner Sharks. Been a real tight second period again, other than those three goals. It was a real goaltending battle. Both Cavallini and Macula really playing exceptionally well in that second period. Channel can't get it out of her own zone. Here's Coyne, ripping it in deep. Cameron Easy, far side. Armin tried to pinch in, couldn't quite hold it though. Spooner's the only Shark out, and Spooner's upended, no call. And it's back out to center, flipped in deep by Brand, and she goes off for a change. D'Arcangelo, give it off to Fast, and that's thrown out to center. Knocked down almost into the open door of the Sharks bench. Oh, and heavy collision between Greco and Lammer, who is, Brittany Howard is free! Stopped by Cavallini. Brittany Howard sprung out on a breakaway once again. Now we've had at least one breakaway opportunity on either side. And Cavallini making sure that one goes right into her glove. Turner on the far side, pinching in Fedeschi. Try to reverse it back, nobody was there. It could be a two-on-one now for Team Coyne with a shot over top of the net. That was Turner, the other number 26 for Team Coyne. Turner still with the puck. Walks the blue line, ricochets around in front. What a save by Macula with the paddle, reaching over to keep that puck out, and the net's knocked off. Oh my goodness. That puck bounced right to the stick of Courtney Turner in front, and Amanda Macula with an incredible stop. Holy cow. What a save. He's off outside the zone. It was Team Coyne who knocked the net off, so that's why the puck's out here, and Sperling couldn't get quite back on side as Atkinson dumped it in, so it's an offside call. That was a highlight reel save by Makala. And if that's not on your top 10 plays of the week, plays of the month, shot easy save for Cavallini off channel. The game slows down a little bit after just an unbelievable save. Spooner won the draw cleanly. Fast faked the shot and now wristed it in, but it was off Lamoureux, and she threw it to the far side. Cameron Easy against Greco, couldn't get it out. Fast, the near side, slapped away from her by Coyne. And now Steckline had it glanced away from her by Spooner, and Gable ripped the stick out of Cavallini's hand as she tried to play the puck. And Cavallini chatting with the official Renee St. Louis. About a maybe potential slashing call against Gable, but nothing on the play. Spooner just tried to throw that in front. Lauren Gable's knocked down in the high slot. Bounces all the way down the ice. An icing call against Team Coyne as Cameron Easy lost an edge at the Sharks' blue line. He's off to the left of Cavallini. Is around in the high slot and gloved down by Harmon. Pass ahead for Lamoureux. Lamoureux tried to feed it in front off a stick and wide. Coyne off the back of the net, but Nurse took that away. And Sarah Nurse is away, fending off the stick check of Cameron Easy and dumping it in. Cameron Easy back on the puck after Cavallini came out to play it, and Kendall Coyne is free. Coyne with a long shot, well wide of the net. Harmon comes to it and sends that one wide as well. Cameron Easy to the line, Steckline winds and fires off her own player in front. Another shot, Makala made the save. Still loose in the slot. Coyne battling for it, and Makala finds it and covers up. 16:20 left. Off one back, Williams. Shot through traffic, off the post. Makala was in the right position to stop it though. Given away in front, Makala. Another save off Panic. Panic. Intercepting that pass. Channel coughed that puck up. Panic up the sharp angle, lost an edge. Channel may have helped her lose an edge a little bit, but no call on the play. Panic again. Glanced away from her by Howard, but Rust got it right back. That was into Larson in front. Another spectacular save by Makala. She is locked in tonight now in the third period. At the line, just bounces out over the stick of Rust. And Team Coyne has to retreat. Fortino buries it through the neutral zone. Lost it, off panic. And Vinkel now, stripped of the puck, but got it right back. Vinkel just dumps it in as her team goes for a wholesale change. Off the skate of Dingledine, and Bravo trying to come up with it off. That's Turner. Bounced in front, just out of the reach of Courtney Turner. Got both Turners, Megan and Courtney, on the ice. Bravo lost it behind her. Brand snagged by Makula. Look at this save again by Makula. Lifting that blocking hand over. And Team Coyne must be feeling like they should be up by two goals right now. But some spectacular play by Makula to keep her team in it. Gamble can't corral the puck in. Fast off the glass and back into the offensive zone. This is Kirion. Played ahead out of the reach of Turner down the ice, but no icing. Fast mishandled the puck. This is Woods trying to dig it out. Brand is there for Team Coyne. Woods as well for the Sharks, and Woods lost her stick. Prevo can't get around stick line. Cleared out to center, knocked right back in by Greco. And Harmon now carries it over the blue line, just onside. Spooner calling for an offside as Lauren Gables spilled once again. Nurse can't get by Lamoureux. Lamoureux taken away by Nurse, but he coughed it up to Harmon. Harmon off a body and wide of the net. Cameron Easy now, the two top lines going at it. Lamoureux deep for Coyne on the near side. Kendall Coyne tried to get the pass across to Harmon, but Nurse broke that up. Cavallini out to play it. That was just out of the reach of Panic and, excuse me, Harmon. And Cavallini had to be sharp on the forecheck from some Spooner Sharks. Off to the right of Cavallini. The linesman cleans up the wreckage from an errant stick that was lost earlier on. Dingledine just knocked that away from Sperling. Or almost did anyway. In the offensive zone for Coyne. Taken away by D'Arcangelo. Up the boards for Howard. Channel now. Carries it in, channel back in front for Howard, just behind her. Bounced off the boards by Sperling, but not out. Now it does get over into the offensive zone, but D'Arcangelo possesses it. Off the skate of Howard. Channel has to retreat. Cortino return to channel. Pass ahead for Brittany Howard. She beats out the icing, no, and gets a shot on Ned. Stopped again by Cavallini. Howard has been buzzing for a second goal tonight. In neutral ice, Fast poked that away from Brand. Might have been a one-on-one. Prevo now across the blue line. Poked away from her, but Fast comes to it. Just bounced it in deep, and Fast trying to block the clearing attempt from Atkinson. Managed to do it, but now she's caught. She has to get back against Vinkel. Vinkel centering pass. Brand was tied up. Good back check by Sydney Kidd. And Atkinson now off the leg of McNeil. And Turner couldn't drag that past McNeil either. Nurse, lovely move to get by, but it's too far ahead of Gable. Cavallini came out to play it. And it's flipped out to center. Fortino off the boards, right into the skates of That's Megan Turner. Now Lamoureux to the line, Steckline. Heavy shot just over top of the net from Harmon. And now Lamoureux back in. She scores! Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson with her second goal of the game. And because Michelle Saunders blew a tire in front, that allowed Lamoureux a free pass to the front of the net. And finally, Team Coyne Greenwind gets one past Amanda Makala, and it's 4-3 midway through the third period. On the face-off, Coyne got it back to Steckline. Spooner on the forecheck. Pass just behind Coyne. She didn't get her stick on it, so an icing call against her squad here. Face off, one back to Fortino. To the far corner, Panic meets it. Panic tied up by Spooner. Steckline stole that away. Here comes Lee Steckline. Takes the center lane and carries it herself. Gave it off to Coyne, and she tried to return it to Steckline in the slot, and her stick was checked. Gable now gets it into the far corner. Nurse to chase it. Try and dig it out. Spooner was there as well. Up the far boards and held in on the near side. Nurse upended. That was a heavy fall, and that's drawn a penalty. And Kelly Panic going off for upending Sarah Nurse right there. Frustrated. She had her stick just in the wrong place and upended Nurse, and now her team's got to kill 2 minutes. Fortino missed the poke check, and Brand tries to flip that past Fast. Can't quite do it. Fast tracked that puck well. D'Arcangelo left it for Fortino behind her own net. Now Fortino skates it out through the center lane. Gave way to D'Arcangelo. D'Arcangelo in the near corner, around to the far side for Howard. Fast at the line. Puck rolled on her, but she managed to hold the line. Prevost in deep. Fortino on the near side. Prevost back out in front, wrapped that one round, and the second attempt goes just wide. Howard, D'Arcangelo again in that far corner. She's pinned up by Williams. Howard trying to dig it out of the feet of the ref. Williams is there as well. And it bounces to the line, poked in by Fast, and Lamoureux now clears it out to center at least, and Fast trying to catch Team Coyne on a change. Howard in the offensive zone, tried to get it back for Fortino. That's cleared out and down the ice by Team Coyne Greenwind. Fast. She takes it herself. Gave it off to Spooner. Gable made sure she got back on side as Spooner takes it round back of the net to the near side. Gable bounced it back to the line. Foss knocked it down and settled it, but bad pass for Fortino. They have to retreat. Right back in though. Gable knocked off the puck by Coyne. Harmon in the near corner. She finds the open space and gets it down the ice. Makala behind the net, left it there for Fast, and Cameronisi on the forecheck. Fortino helped her out though. Giving off to Fast again, ahead for Nurse. Sidestepped Larson, chipped it ahead. Gable tried to spin and get that in front, but Spooner was behind the net instead. A as the penalty has expired. Centering pass, Larson couldn't get a good stick on it. Banked ahead. Gable trying to dig that out. Now she's pinned Panic against the boards. And Panic just putting her feet together and making sure that puck doesn't go anywhere. Again, Caroline Prevo with the wraparound attempt. Almost jammed that past Cavallini. Steckline. Excuse me, that's Channel. Steckline's for the dark team. Turner. Move it off. Here it goes. Pass ahead for Brand. Give away in front. Turner fired that one. Just kicked out off the toe of Makula. Howard. Get that pass, Rustin. Howard again with that fancy white stick of hers. Fires that just wide. Those white blades look real sharp. That fired out and down the ice. I personally quite like those sticks with the white, at least the bottom, that Brittany Howard's got. Rough giveaway by Greco in front. Gave Courtney Turner an opportunity. Fast. Can't corral the puck. At the near blue line, Prevo. Threaded it ahead for Woods. Now Fortino jumping up. Back for McNeil. Shot kicked out. Cavallini made the stop. And now Coyne is away. She was hanging out of the blue line. Kendall Coyne scores! Two goals for Kendall Coyne. And she's given her team a 5-3 lead. What a breakout pass as well. Finding Coyne just hanging out here at the near blue line. This is Lamoureux. Big slap shot, scores! That's another hat trick today, this one for Jocelyn Lamoureux-Davidson. I think Makula might have thought that was going wide. But Lamoureux with a big slap shot. Makula just shrugging her shoulders, stunned that that one got by her. And now it's 6-3. Line held that in at the line. In deep, Cameron Easy. Give it away in front again, and Fortino cut that one off at the last second. It's Goldberg is alone in front. Badeski trying to muscle that puck ahead. It does, it's slapped out, but all the way down the ice. And Jessica Platt was trying to beat that icing out, but nothing doing. Jessica Platt, of course, the first transgender woman to play in the CWHL, continued her representation for LGBTQ. With the PWHPA, of course, that pass blocked by Fortino, but it gets back out in front again. Larson couldn't quite handle it. Howard runs into Atkinson, and those two go at each other, and they're still chatting. The linesman has to come in and break them up. Howard goes off for Spooner. Platt trying to muscle this up the far boards, and she's taken down as well. Fired out, Nurse just onside. Nurse in alone. What a save by Cavallini. Two breakaways, Brittany Howard and Sarah Nurse trying to do the same thing on Cavallini, and she's having none of it. Great breakout pass by Laura Fortino, but see there again, right into the glove of Cavallini. They're not fooling her that easy. Spooner stole the puck and made sure her teammates were onside. Taken into the back wall. Lamoureux knocks her down, but Gable stole the puck. Gable working Rust over. Spooner got it back. Tried to get it out in front, but he was tied up. Rust, pass picked off. Gable fell, though. Spooner just dragged it in. And Nurse now, one too many moves as she tried to fake out Cavallini. And the Coyne Greenwind bench was calling for an offside. Fast across for Nurse again. Waits for the rest of her teammates to get it back on the ice. One time shot from Gamble is blocked in front. And that's fired in deep by Saunders. Lamoureux takes over. And Turner stumps it in. Megan Turner going off for a change. Just over 3.5 minutes left to go. Lots of work to be done for the Spooner Sharks if they want to get back in this one now. Off the boards and in, tipped by Panic. Channel is back. Channel off the skate of Cameron Easy. And Coyne got that back for Steckline, but she bobbled it a little bit. Kidd tied her up. Prevost on the loose puck. Kidd goes to the front of the net. Centering pass cut by Panic. There goes Coyne. In the middle for Panic, just out of her reach. Prevost tied her up. Prevost chipped the puck ahead. Steckline got there. Flipped ahead by Panic and dumped in deep by Coyne. McAleod to play it. Channel to the far side. Dingledine kept it out. And with the help of McNeil, it gets to the neutral zone. Woods tried to hit Dingledine. She was going down the left wing side, centering pass. And McNeil was tied up. Flipped right back ahead by Greco. She gives chase. Cavallini to the far side, Kirion. Just out of the reach of Brand. And Howard didn't really have much of an option with that pass, is flipped ahead. And that is Goldberg. Puck stolen by Fedeski. Chipped ahead, but Spooner Sharks can't really maintain control of it. Might have an offensive opportunity here. Platt got it to D'Arcangelo. Fedeski pinching in. D'Arcangelo to Platt. Platt wrists a shot. That's right into the glove of Cavallini. Minute and 43 left. This game could be all but over. D'Arcangelo with a good keep. Nice pass across to Platt, and she puts that on, tried to get it through traffic. Brittany Howard in front. Howard's on the puck now. Return to the line, tipped in front. Platt comes to it. And D'Arcangelo now spins and fires. Platt behind the net. Howard on the far side. Centering pass, knocked away by Cavallini. Fedeski, slap shot well wide of the net. Howard. Down in deep now, taken away by Williams. Up the near boards, flipped out to center. Two on one now, Larson and Lamoureux. Lamoureux into the high slot, she still got it. Shot, stopped by Mäkelä. We come to the final minute, and they try to spring Gable. Gable takes it round back of the net. On comes Nurse. Gable tried to get it in deep for Nurse. Lamoureux intercepted that. Fortino. Just onside, lanced away from her. Spurling to the puck. On the far side, intercepted by Spooner and right back. Spooner over the blue line. Poked away by Harmon. Flipped out to center. Final 30 seconds of day one of this, the fourth stop on the Dream Gap Tour in North York. Fast, up the right wing side. Stick handles, looks for an option, threw it on net. Cavallini made the stop. Turner in her own zone, tied up by Gable. Tried to get it out in front, it was blocked. This is panic. He'll just kill the final few seconds. Lost an edge though. Spooner gonna run out of time. And that does it. Day one is complete at Herbert Carnegie. 6-3 the score for Team Coyne over the Spooner Sharks. And we'll have the player of the game presentation as well as the three stars in just a moment. And I will head down once again for one final interview of the day. Now here ice level with Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson. They had a hat trick in this game despite some incredible saves from Amanda Makula. What seemed to be working for you specifically tonight?
Well, I think after the first period, I was just focusing on getting the pucks in the net. And we had some good plays where some line mates created some space for me and just got some lucky bounces and puck went in tonight.
Now, of course, you recently made your return to the ice with your sister. And what's this event been like now, being back on the ice and seeing the crowd and just the atmosphere today?
There's nothing better than being a mom, and so to have Nelson and my sister's boy Mickey, cheering us on from home, it's really special. And to see all the young girls out here today, this is the third game tonight, and it's still a packed rink, and that's why we're here, is to create a dream for these girls, and so hopefully we're doing that.
And now to go back to your play, you have some incredible puck control, and you mentioned all the girls here watching you tonight. What would you say to them that allowed you to become so good at controlling that puck?
I had four older brothers growing up, and so if we wanted to play, we had to play hard to keep up with them. And so, like, you just got to get out on the ice, on the outdoor rinks, not when it's raining here in Toronto, but get out there and just play. I mean, ultimately, we're all doing what we're doing here because we love to play, and so find that enjoyment and just have fun. No coaches, no parents, just get out with some teammates and just have fun out there.
Well, thank you, Jocelyn. That's Jocelyn Lamoureux Davidson, hat trick and first star of the game. That wraps up day one of this stop on the Dream Gap Tour here in North York. I've been Jared Bapty calling these past three games for you. Thank you, Jocelyn. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in on YouTube and CBC Gem. We'll be back here tomorrow morning at 9:30 for game 4 of the Secret Deodorant Dream Gap Tour.